This was arguably the ugliest game I've ever witnessed, with seemingly both teams unable to hit any shots to start off the game, and the overall low level of energy and effort shown by the Warriors. The Grizzlies without Ja Morant led all game until the last minute, and I want to break down how Golden State was able to execute a comeback in the fourth quarter. Let's get to it. With Memphis up a concerning 12 points, you have two players in bad positioning, helping off one pass away from Golden State shooters. Kick out and you have a tough matchup, with Poole on a great defensive player and high school teammate in Jackson Jr. However, he gets dribble penetration, forcing Jones to help, leaving Williams for the two weak side shooters. Cross-court pass hits Wiggins, who makes a simple basketball read to an open Porter Jr. Shout out Otto for being the only Warrior to hit any shots the first three quarters, as he drains his wide-open three. The Grizzlies started Steven Adams, and with a slower big man, their defensive coverage was to show and not switch matchups. Here, Porter Jr. slips the first screen, and Looney comes for a second pick. But Williams' job is to fight over and allow Steven Adams to show on this and not allow the switch. JP makes a slick pass to the roll man in Looney for the easy dunk and is a single-digit deficit again. With the shot clock winding down, here's a Memphis defensive collapse. Porter Jr. hands it off to JP, but both Grizzlies decide to double on this, even though, like I mentioned before, their coverage was a stick to their own man. This miscommunication allows Porter Jr. to receive the ball on the wing and get his man in Williams up in the air with a nice shot fake and relocate for an open three. That's twice Memphis collapse in the waning seconds of the shot clock. I mentioned before with the big, the job is to not switch, as it leaves Adams on an island with a quicker guard. Here Draymond comes for an instant drag screen and Williams is unable to fight over, leaving Steven Adams to switch on an island for a dance with Stephen Curry. Easy blow by allowing dribble penetration, and Dylan Brooks correctly rotates down to help, but fouls Steph on this and one reverse layup. On a sweet out of bounds play, you can see JP get the ball and both him and Draymond direct Porter Jr. for the weak side action. Dylan Brooks is top locking Curry first, as Wiggins goes for the decoy cut and Porter Jr. comes for the pin down. Veteran move by Steph to throw Brooks behind him, and Memphis once again is not switching this with Kyle Anderson, forcing Brooks to trail and give Steph an open look from downtown, and he knocks it down. Baseline out of bounds play, you can see Brooks anxiously pointing this setup, knowing a shooter will flare out. However, his own positioning isn't defending this whatsoever, so I'm a little confused here. Klay Thompson slides through, and Poole Wiggins sets this classic elevator screen, forcing Jones to chase around them, but just enough of an opening for Thompson to drain this long two-pointer. Bad defense by Memphis. The Warriors ended the game knowing the defensive coverages on these out-of-bound plays. Steph Curry receives the ball at the top and Green comes for the screen, but knowing Memphis is trying to fight over and avoid switches and mismatches at all costs, Dylan Brooks tries to cheat the screen and Steph knows this, so he instantly rejects his pick with Draymond's man and Jackson Jr. on the wrong side of the pick, getting an open pull-up three-pointer to go. Alright, well that was a game I wanted to end badly, as I thought neither team wanted to win, but the Grizzlies lost this one down a stretch with bad shot selection and overall low IQ plays. At the end of the day, a win's a win, as the Grizzlies suffer without Ja Morant's presence and playmaking abilities. The Warriors were able to execute in the fourth quarter down by as many as 12 points, with brilliant out-of-bounds plays and clutch defensive possessions, not to mention making your own damn free throws. If you like this quick breakdown, feel free to subscribe and I'll see you guys tomorrow night with hopefully an end to this series in 5 games.